Good afternoon. Welcome to my video tutorial on stress and deflection analysis of a truss using ANSYS. So here is our simple truss problem. There are three nodes, node 1, node 2 and node 3. The node 1 is fixed. Node 2 is having displacement in the x direction. The force of 40 kN is applied here. And node 3, a force of 30 kN is applied vertically downwards. The modulus of elasticity is 2 into 10 raised to 5 MPa, and the cross sectional area of each element is given to be 50 mm². We have to determine the element stiffness matrix, global stiffness matrix analytically, the nodal displacements, that is stresses in each element, and the reaction forces. So just a quick analytical part. The first step is discretization, in which you discretize the object into elements and nodes. So as you can see, this is node 1, this is node 2, and this is node 3. This is the element 1, which is made up of node 1 and node 2. This is the element 1, element 2 and element 3. So element 1 is made up of node 1 and node 2, element 2 is made up of node 2 and node 3, and element 3 is made up of node 1 and node 3. This is written is here in the table format. Now the problem is very similar to the beam problem. The difference is that in case of beam, the DOF per node was 1. However, in case of truss, the DOF per node is 2. It can move, every node can move in two directions, U as well as V. So the dimension of global stiffness matrix will be 6 by 6. If there are 4 nodes, then dimension of global stiffness matrix will be 2 into 4 is equal to 8 by 8. Likewise, if the number of nodes increases, the dimension of global stiffness matrix increases. Now the element stiffness matrix are found for element 1, here 1, 2, 3, 4, element 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and element 3, 1, 2, 5, 6. These matrices are combined to form the global stiffness matrix 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The global load vector. Now for node 1, as it is fixed, the reactions are formed. In x direction it is R1x, and in y direction it is R1y, which is written in the global load vector R1x, R1y. For node 2, in x direction the force of 40,000 newton is applied in right direction, and it is fixed vertically, so a reaction is formed R2y. For node 3, the force in x direction is 0 and the force in y direction is 30,000 downwards, so it is taken as negative. So this is how global load vector is formed. Now similar, the global nodal displacement vector is taken as U1, V1, U for node 1, for node 2, U2, V2, and for node 3, U3, V3. Now our relationship between global stiffness, nodal displacement and load is K into U is equal to F. In this condition, the node 1 is fixed, so u1 and v1 is 0. Also, node 2 is fixed in y direction, hence its y displacement v2 is 0. Hence u1, v1 and v2 are 0. Now, by using elimination approach, eliminate row 1, column 1, row 2, column 2, and row 4, column 4. This results in the matrix u2, u3 and v3. Solving these equations, you will get u2 2.4 mm, v3 minus 2.4 mm and u3 3.2 mm. So the global displacement matrix will be written as this. To find the stresses, we use the formula E by L minus Cx minus Cy, Cx, Cy, u1, u1, u2, u2. The element 1 stress is found to be 800 Newton per mm square, and stress in element 2 is found to be minus 600 Newton per mm square, and stress in element 3 is found to be 0. To find the reaction forces, just equate to find R1x, just solve the first row. To find R1y, just solve the second row. And to find R2y, just solve the fourth row. G solved here. R1x is found to be minus 40,000 Newton. R1y is found to be 0 Newton, and R2y is found to be minus 30 Newton. So this is how the example is solved analytically. Now we will solve this using the help of ANSYS. Now let's change the working directory from bar to truss. I will just create a folder called bar, called truss. And just browse this to truss. Change the file name to truss. And click run. Now we will follow the same steps as we did in bar 12. So just click on preferences, structural, okay. Next step is preprocessor. We will go step by step, element type, add, edit or delete. Just add this beam element and click OK. Close. For beam element, there is no need of rail constant, so we will skip this one. Material properties. The material properties are the modulus of electricity is taken as 2 into 10 raised to 5. So we'll take that. Material models, structure, linear, elastic, and isotropic to E5, and Poisson's ratio is taken as 0.3. Just click on OK and close it. Material properties. So next step is sections. It is a beam section, common sections. Now the area is given to be 50 mm square of each element. So this all the three elements will have same cross sectional area of 50 mm square. So we have to just calculate the cross section is circular, and we have to just calculate the radius of the each element. I'll just calculate the radius 15. Pi by 4 d square is equal to 50. So d square is equal to 50 into 4 divided by 3.14 root and divided by 2 is found to be 3.990. So now just click on OK. So the beam section is created. The next step is modeling. The first node is at 00. Second node is at 600 distance in x direction from node 1. And third node's coordinate are 600 and 800. So we input them, create nodes in active CS. Node 1 is taken at 0, 0, 0. Apply. Node 2 is taken as 600. Apply. And node 3 is taken as 600 and 800. Now I will click on OK. Now I will change the elements. I will join the nodes to elements. Now the attributes of each element is same. So we have created one attribute called section 1. The radius we have given is 3.99. So this section has radius of 3.99 mm. Auto number through nodes, node 1, node 2, apply, node 2, node 3, apply, node 3, node 1, okay. Now these elements are created. So this ends the preprocessor part. Modeling part. Now loads. In loads, the node 1 is fixed. The node 1 is completely fixed. The node 2 can move in x direction. So its y direction is fixed. Y and z directions are fixed. It can move in x direction. So we'll give the displacement loads here on node 1 and node 2. So just click on apply, structural, displacement on nodes 1. Just click on apply. All DOF as it is fixed. So click on apply. Now node 2, click on OK. just unselect all UF. Its UX can move, so I will not select this. UX, UI and user are 0. So I will select that and click on OK. I have applied the displacement loads on node 1 and node 2. After that, apply force load 40,000 newton in on node 2 in x direction and minus 30,000 newton on node 3 in y direction. On nodes, apply in x direction, it is taken as 40,000, and on node 3, just click on this. I'll change this to FY and minus 30,000. Just click on OK. So the forces are created. Now this ends the pre-processor part. In solution, just click on solution, solve, current LS and OK. Solution is done. In general post processor, you want to see first the displacement at nodes. So just click on list results. The nodal solution. UF solution, displacement vector sum, and OK. So it is found to be 2.4 on node 2 and 2.4 in x direction on node 2, 3.2 in x direction on node 3, and minus 2.4 in y direction on node 3. We will see whether it matches or not. -2.4 So our solution is found to be correct. Just save this file. Just rename it as reflection and save. Similarly, plot the reflection results, plot results into plot, nodal solution, UF solution, displacement vector sum, and deform shape with undeformed model. Just click on OK. You will get to see the original part, the original shape of truss, and the deflected shape of truss. Just plot controls and hard copy to file. Just choose the format and rename it. Okay. This is the deflection part. To find the stresses in elements, there is an option called element table, like we did in the bar problem. Define table, add the effective number for equivalent strength is 0. We are calculating stress, so its effective number for strain is 0. User label for item is SAXN by sequence number LS and 1. Just click on OK and close. After that, just list the element table, click on SAXN and OK. The stresses are found to be 800.32 and minus 600.26, which is, and third is 0, which is same. Just save this stress and save. Just plot this and OK. Capture the image. And for reactions, list results, reaction solution, all reactions, and we'll get to see the reactions. Fx for node 1 is minus 40,000 in x direction. R1x is minus 40,000 and R2y is minus is 30,000. So this is found to be correct. So today we have done a deflection analysis and stress analysis of a 2D truss. In the next tutorial, we are going to perform the stress and deflection analysis of a mechanical plate using ANSYS. So have a good day.